World Championships of Ping Pong. And there it is. Maxi Schmierer is the world champion. Once again, on top of the top table, Maxi Schmierer. A slower ball from Alex. Big and he takes it. The new world champion of ping pong. It's Andrew Bagley. The two biggest stars in the sport have made it through. For Maxi, goes for the big one. Bagley's consistency takes the match. Before 14 all in the final game, and there's the power from Huang. Wang Shibo wins by the smallest of margins.
They are both ready to go.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome for match four, representing Russia, Maxim Shmirev, and representing England, it's Andrew Bagley.
Andrew Bagley with a determined look on his face. Maxim Shmirev, such a proven performer at this level, but hasn't won here for a few years now. We've been commenting on how he's rather patched up, but he seems to be moving free enough, Darius, as he's possibly the two most famous players in the history of the World Championship of Ping Pong going head-to-head. What a clash. Let's hand over to Colin and Tony.
Thanks, Tony. Well, this may be the one that we've come to watch in this session. Three-time world champion Maxim Shmirov of Moscow in Russia against two-time world champion Andrew Bagley of Milton Keynes in England. Andrew looking intently there. So, Maxim to serve. One of the biggest matches of all time. The winner will play another ex-world champion, Wan Yan Wei Hao, in the quarterfinal. Wow, this is just the last 16. Some fantastic players now. And there already we see the class. We see the pedigree of both players. And Maxim's come out with a very, very harsh forehand to start with. Very, very confident, very well executed. And the very, very first point of the match on the TV table. Great skill. For Bagley to reach it. Great shot again from Andrew. Good power.
7-9.
And then here we see earlier, three drop shots. There's the first one, gets back into position. Oh my word, a second drop shot. I can't believe it, a third one. And that one, the ball had just dropped underneath the table. Not possible to get. Fantastic from Maxim Shmirev. Good combination of great power, great thought, great touch.
What that also showed, Colin, was just how determined Bagley is never to give up a point.
8-9.
Andrew won't give you anything on court. If he can beat you 15-love, 15-love, he'll do it. He doesn't mind how long the rallies are to get there either. Keeps attacking, keeps staying consistent as possible.
9-8.
You have to earn everything you get from Andrew.
Now, interestingly, Colin, sorry, they did play in China, these two, recently, and Bagley will take confidence from that. He did emerge victorious in that match, and that wasn't that long ago. So that will give him some confidence, and he'll need it here. It's got tight now, 9-all.
Yeah, so 8-5, and then Maxim's won 4 of the last 5 points. Now there, Maxim played a cross court, but just outside the crossover. Andrew was kind of turned inside out, couldn't get his shoulders sideways to get the power into the ball, so it dropped into the net. Very smart play from Maxim. His perception is right on the button right now.
That was good from Andrew. We saw that early in the game. You see this backhand down the line and stretching Maxim. Maxim had started to play more and more forehands on that backhand corner, so I think he needs to use that a lot, Andrew. Just keep spreading Maxim wide.
So Maxime, who was just a tiny bit poorly, he said yesterday, a little bit of a bad tummy, but he says today he feels back on it and sharp. And certainly looks at anyone that stays 10-0 against Andrew Bagley has to be right on it. So physically strong. The bandages are not doing him any harm at all. He's looking like he's in good control of himself, very athletic. Forehand from the backhand side. Running round again to get his forehand in. He's having to play from one side and then the other against Andrew. But he's been up for it the last several points. Seems focus and decision making. It's been second to none. This really is world class. This could be the final, and this is happening in the last 16. Amazing. Oh, that's the best backhand of the day. Down the line. There you go, Andrew. Beauty.
Yeah, if Maxim's trademark is it's forehand from the backhand side, Andrew's is definitely the backhand from the backhand side. Hits it so hard, times it so well. No chance at all there for Maxim.
Plays the same backhand again, and Maxim reached it and played his forehand back. And then Maxim's backhand, that time across court. What a brilliant rally. There's the big backhand down the line. How did Maxim get that back? Put in a chop and then attack the backhand for the winner. Well, enough of that. Andrew's saying that he wants the double point ball. Change the rhythm of the match. 11-12 down. A double pointer would put him 13-12 up. So a canny judgment, I think, from Andrew. The white ball is worth two to the server. And he's in. Stayed consistent there, Tony, didn't he? He didn't blast it when the ball was higher.
Yeah, he's trusted to really good placement here. Look at this. He manages change not overly powerful, those forehands, but kept them really wide on the backhand side of Shmyrov. Stopped him running around and playing a forehand.
Yeah, very thoughtful placement. Keep maxing wide of the backhand. Twice he did that. Beautiful. So, Bagley back in the lead. Toing and froing beautifully this match. First to 15. Shmyrov could take his double point ball now. Yes. He's chosen not to. Yes. So fighting back from 13-12 down. Personally, I'll take the double point now.
Well, could be that he's feeling confident. Maybe he feels he can take this game without it. Let's see what happens.
Short serve down the line. We see the angle that Maxime got right on the white line. Didn't go for length, but went for width with that forehand. Look how wide that was. Andrew almost falling over. Tried to play it down the line, but his body weight was going so much to the right, he couldn't pull it back into the table. 13-all. No one can predict this. Maxime bouncing the ball on the table on his back, trying to settle his own nerves. Good backspin from Maxime. Oh, came off the top of the net and he made it. There's the drop shot again. And that time, Andrew couldn't get to the first one. What a great rally this was. 14. Backspin from Maxime, put him back into it. Backhand down the line. And then the trademark forehands from the backhand side. And then we've seen it before.
Yeah, he practiced the magic that one earlier, drop shot.
Here's one I prepared earlier. Game point to Maxime Shmyrov.
That's one of my favourite rallies so far this championship. Fantastic.
Andrew serving to save the game. First game, best of three. The business end. Oh, what a block for Andrew down the line. Maxime ran around, got his forehand in, chose to go across court. And then Tony, as you were saying, the backhand of Andrew Bagley from the backhand side, his trademark. Trademark against trademark, and it's 14-all in the first. Sudden death, this point takes the first game. Bagley serving, is that an advantage, Tony?
Yeah, definitely puts him in charge of what happens here. He can either start it with a nice short serve or go straight into a fast rally with a quick one. See what happens.
He's gone short with the serve. Got his forehand in. Maxime picks it off the net, gets around. And the trademark forehand down the line from the backhand side. Maxime takes the first game, 15-14. That is an absolute cracker, and I can't wait to see more of this. This is how he did it. So, good rally. Maxime backhand, two backhands, and then around, forehand down the line again. Andrew unable to stop the power down the line wide of his forehand. First game to Maxime Shmyriev, and he's delighted. Well done, Magic Maxime. Supported and coached there by Dmitry Bobrov. Getting some ideas from the corner, ready for the second game. And in the back, there we've got the meat tower, Chris Doran, little and large. Laurel and Hardy there. And
there's a whole foot between them, apparently, Colin. 5'8" and 6'8".
Is Vlad even 5'8"? So that's going to be... Both of these players are going to be playing later, not against each other. Just make the ball come down. Both players needing the towel down. You see, very, very hot. Perspiration everywhere now. The TV lights do make this a draining environment as well. Players are used to it and they love it, but it is demanding. Gladiatorial battle and a war of attrition as much as of skill. Maxime backhand chop again. It's a little bit high, but he's staying in the rally. Not that one. Too high, too long.
Really good variation of pace there from Andrew. You see him throwing a slower forehand when Maxime went back. And then I think Maxime was looking to come back in, and then you see extra power now. This one, just a little bit of increase of speed.
Love that variation of pace. World-class thinking from Andrew Bagley. 10-4 up. Looking to square the match at 1-1. Maxime going for a couple 11. Of big ones. I think maybe he's just working out just how hard he can hit the ball without going off the end. But then he found out he can't hit it quite that hard. Maybe he's preparing for the third game in the back of his mind. Little nervous movements again from Maxime preparing for his serve. Backhands down the line from Maxime. The third one went off the end.
12-4.
A little look at the score there, 12-4 down. He knows that's a long way out to come back against Andrew Bagley.
Yeah, I think in the back of Maxim's mind now, Colin, he'll be preserving energy for what he knows is a third end to come.
I think he's thinking ahead and just trying to get everything in place for a third. Great block from Maxime. Backhand across court, gets around. Andrew was in the coconut shy there for a while. Couldn't beat it all off. Classic Maxime. Fast serve across court with the backhand. When it comes back across the diagonal, run round, forehand down the line. And that's not just any old forehand, is it, Tony? Crikey.
It's not. And what impresses you there, you can see he doesn't actually turn until after Andrew's hit it. That's really quick foot movement.
It is. 47 years of age, and he's so quick to get around.
37.
Well, a couple of little shouts from the crowd. Nervy crowd, I think, in terms of the Andrew Bagley supporters. 13-7. Doesn't want to lose another couple here. Get him into more nervous territory. Maxime just tempting him, changing the pace, putting side spin on the ball, just off the side with a big forehand.
14-7.
I think Maxime's already got his game plan for the third worked out, and he's just thinking through how he's going to do that, using this game as a kind of a warm-up and preparation for it. He's going back and chopping again. You wouldn't normally see that.
8-14.
Just throw Andrew off his rhythm and then come out with a different style at the beginning of the third game. You hear the harshness of the bat on ball, no rubber involved. Just a bit of sandpaper on plywood. Goes back to chop again. And that's 15-8 to Andrew Bagley. I think Maxime knew he'd met his match there. Bagley got a big lead at 10-4. But Bagley has blown his double point ball. And Maxim has one left. That is a little bit of an advantage for this third game, to have that in your locker.
Yeah, it certainly is. And when we saw Maxim play yesterday, he won the first game, lost the second about 15-6, and then came through strongly in the third. So he's physically very strong still. Even though he's 47, he's not afraid to go the distance.
Yeah, he knows how to win a final game. He's done it before, and he's done it in the final of this competition. Yeah, he had a tough one, didn't he, against Christophe Reynal from France, left-hander, but came through in the third game. What you don't want, of course, is too many games that go to a final game on your run into this stage of the tournament, because otherwise you might not get rid of the fatigue between one round and the next. Dmitry Bobrov, great player in his own right. He's put out by Chen Jia, very close match. Lovely style, Dmitry Bobrov. And Maxime talking to him this morning, I said, who's your favourite player of all the ping-pong players? He said, Dmitry Bobrov. He actually likes his countrymen, even though he's regarded as a better player than him. But lovely style, Dmitry. And then here, Steve Bagley, keeping Andrew very, very clear and focused about what he's got to do. Look at that. You can see the body language there. Steve's looking confident and relaxed at the end, having dispatched his advice.
And I think we'll see Andrew now being very intense. We'll see him celebrating every point, especially in his early stages. Every point he gets, he'll be using it to spur him on further.
Third game, Shmirov to serve,
Lavoe. See both players muttering to themselves, kind of urging themselves on.
Yeah, so if you're looking for a theoretical fine line, you'd say Maxime's got service, which we think is an advantage. Very slight, but discernible.
Yeah.
And also, he's got a double point ball to come. So theoretically, if these are evenly matched, maybe Maxime has just that time across court. Smart tactics from both players. So nothing at all in it, 5-all final game. Andrew Bagley to serve. Short serve this time. Backhand down the line, that time he did keep it down.
6-5.
Well done, Andrew. Soft forehand flick and then changed the pace. Backhand really pushed it, and he knew that he'd hit the ball down more, and that worked. Appreciative look from Maxime. Great respect for each other's games. Same serve again.
5-7. Ends, please.
So as they change, halfway through this third game, Andrew's sneaked a little lead, 2 points. They're also swapping bats, of course, Colin.
Yeah, they've got to leave the bat on their side of the table, go round and pick up the other bat. And there we have it. 5 ply blade, I think. Maybe 7, but I think it's 5. A little bit of sandpaper. People say, you know, sandpaper doesn't have that have a lot of grip, but not really. Very, very slight in terms of the way that you can spin a table tennis ball from it. And it's a throwback to the 1920s, so a 100-year-old game being played in the modern age by the top stars. And they're loving it. Andrew's had enough of waiting. Long push return from Andrew. He's forced away from the table.
6,
just caught the edge,
7.
But what a forehand down the line this is. See, it's so deep, it just catches the edge. What a great shot.
The old 1-2. Forehand across court, forehand down the line. Great stuff from Maxime, right on the edge, literally. Seems still a point behind. Still with the double point ball saved up. Again, the long stroke you were talking about across court, Tony.
6.
Yeah, and this two-point cushion is vital, Colin, for Andrew, because, of course, Maxim, later in the game, still has this double-point ball available. So if he can keep at least 2 points ahead, he knows that if Maxim plays that, he won't jump into the lead.
Yep. Steve Bagley thrilled with that rally from behind the barriers.
Nine, six.
Well, failed to return the serve. 3 point cushion. One more serve from Bagley to come. Short serve to the forehand. Andrew's peppered that short to the forehand with his serve in this third game. Here we see it again. There. Maxime not able to get back and comfortable in position to play the backhand to follow up that forehand shot.
That's right, it's the longest recovery, isn't it? You have to come in short on the forehand side and then the deep to the backhand. You've got to go a long way to be ready for the next shot. Clever tactics from Bagley.
Yeah, it's hard to play into the ball and get your weight transference when your body's still going back from the last shot that was close to the net. See Max's forefinger covered. Just protect his finger against the sandpaper.
7-10.
So I'm thinking, is he going to play double point? He is not. No, doesn't look like he is.
No, he's still available. 7-10. He's a brave man that doesn't think he needs it.
Oh, he hurt me.
I think that's very wise, Maxime.
Double point ball, Schmiller.
These players have such belief that maybe they think, well, I'll win the next one, so I don't need it yet. And that kind of thinking that can go on and on.
Yeah, we've seen this a lot from Max, haven't we? He does take his time in between points. It's very hot out there, and I think he feels he's getting advantage from slowing Andrew down as well.
Yeah, making Andrew wait is tough for Andrew. Andrew's got to wait and apply his focus, not knowing when the ball's coming. The big one, 2 points on this one for Maxime. He misses it! Andrew Bagley survived
11,
against the double-point ball, and not only the double-point ball, but the double-point ball several times at 70 or 80 miles an hour. Maxime is distraught that that one's gone off the end of the table, and the opposite emotion for Andrew Bagley, who is now, I think, 4 points ahead.
Yeah, and surviving was right. He faced a barrage of powerful forehands there from Shmyrov. Just kept staying in that rally, placing that forehand back on the table, making Shmyrov hit another one, and eventually he missed.
Oh, that was a bit lucky for Andrew. Maxime frustrated, 12-7. So you just see the ball just hit the top of the net here for Andrew. There it is.
Andrew forgetting he's already used his double point ball, saying, can I have another one?
Andrew goes to the double point ball, he's told he can't have it. So,
12,
both players
7.
Slowing it down now. No one wants to start this next rally very soon. Andrew thinking hard, taking as much time as Maxime has. Short to the forehand again, and the long backhand across court. He's done that several times.
8.
Maxime there opting to play it more slowly after the return of serve. A little change of pace keeps Maxime in it.
Yeah, Shang is still thinking clearly in spite of the pressure he's under.
Come on, this one.
Yeah, amazing presence by these players tactically. He's gone back and chopping, even on his own serve. And then the backhand attack, and he misses the forehand attack. Well, very interesting,
13.
That one. Fast serve, and then deliberately goes back to chop the ball from away from the table. Then the backhand was good, and that's the second forehand on the trot that he's missed. Gives Bagley a 5-point lead. Steve in the background, urging Andrew Bagley on. Winner plays Yan Weihao, last year's semi-finalist, 2017 champion. Backhand down the line from Andrew Bagley. Another forehand off the end. Maxime just lost his balance and range slightly with that forehand. Beautiful backhands from Andrew. One down the line, one across court. Down the line again. Didn't need the forehand. Match point, Andrew Bagley. A place in the quarterfinals and a guaranteed $3,000. Maxime goes back and defends again, like he did at the end of the second game. Nothing more he can do. Andrew Bagley picked up in the last 16. We have to say goodbye to a wonderful warrior, Maxime Shmyriev of Russia. Three times champion, but out in the last 16. What an awful draw for him to meet Bagley at this stage. But a fantastic match from both players.
Yeah, the quality of that match, Colin, was incredible. As you say, two world champions, some terrific long rallies all the way through, great power. And as we see, the ability to mix it up, defend, attack. Game had everything, didn't it?
It did. Maxime looks like he knew he was beaten at the very end. Nothing more that he could do. The backspin goes off the end with a bit of sigh. It's over for Maxime Shmyriev. So well done, Andrew Bagley, and back to Tony.
Brilliant from Bagley, who is through to the last eight, and what a test he had as well. Three Chinese players through to the last eight in the top half of the draw, and Andrew Bagley, and of those four that are in the quarterfinals on the top half of the draw, two former world champions. So mouth-watering